Greetings everyone, my name is Anne. Hope you're all doing well. Today we are unhauling some books. I don't have many shelves or much space, so it's quite important that I try and curate the books that I have. And I've just had a stack of books that have been taking up space on my shelf that I really need to get rid of. So let's just jump straight into it. First one up on my list is Labyrinth by Kate Moss. This book came out around the time where people were all about the theories of Illuminati and secret societies and all that stuff. And so this book has a lot of secrecy going on. There's a bit of an underlying mystery throughout the book as well. I read this so long ago that the plot is long gone to me and the blurb isn't really that much helpful. But from what I remember, it's a hunt for the Holy Grail, and we have two skeletons that have been found in a cave. And so there are dual timelines in the book. So you're going and you're following what happened many, many years ago, like hundreds of years ago within the story, set in France. So we have that sort of setting there, and you're finding out what happened there alongside modern day with the secret society as well. I remember this being a fun read when I initially first read it. Sounded really interesting and fun, but I did not know that it was a series. So I think I looked up on Goodreads quite recently and I saw that there were more books in this. To be really honest, there are other books that I do want to get to. So whether or not it's a series that I'm going to jump straight back into, I'm not really sure, but I know that if I did want to, I can always pick it up from my library. So there's no real point in keeping a book that is kind of a bit meh to me at the moment on my shelves. Now I have Troy by Adele Geras. I got this in high school, so this is a very old copy, and I've read it a couple of times, or a few times now since I've got it, but I haven't read it in a very, very long time or reread it. So this follows Helen of Troy. It's based around the siege and sort of that Greek mythology. I've not read any other stories around Greek mythology or this story in particular. I do kind of want to read more mythical books or historically well-known mythical stories. This was fun when I read it. I don't know how I feel if I reread it, but because I do want to try other stories, I don't think I want to keep this on my shelf. It was fun when I read it as a teen. I don't know if it's something I want to pick up right now, because like I said, there are so many other retellings or versions that I could get stuck into. And I think I want to read more of the academic side of this mythology, so less so of a retelling. Actually, I think I want to get the basics of the story, so that when I do read retellings, I know if, not if it's historically accurate, if it actually follows the plot of what the original stories were, if that makes sense. But yeah, not really one for me. It's been there for a while, getting rid. I've got Girl on a Train by Paula Hawkins. This one was one I did look forward to reading. I don't really usually read thrillers or books within this genre, so I was very excited to pick it up because of the hype and the movie was coming out. I can't say I enjoyed this book. So it follows quite an unreliable narrator. A woman's gone missing. There's investigations into it. It's quite a well-known case, and so people are trying to find out what happened to this woman. The main character that we are following, she's very, very unreliable. She has a drinking problem, so tends to drink a lot and blacks out, and people get frustrated with her, so it's quite hard to believe what she's talking about and what she's finding out. She takes it upon herself to try and find out about the disappearance, because she sees the missing woman on, so basically she sees the missing woman on her balcony, and she passes them every day on her way to work, and she kind of builds this picture of this couple in her mind. So when the woman goes missing, she takes it upon herself to try and solve the mystery. Fun in theory, but I didn't really enjoy it in execution, because I found myself being very frustrated with the character or the main lead, and I felt like people were going round and round in circles. I would give thrillers a go again, but this one wasn't fun for me. But I might give the movie a go. Let me know if you think the movie is any better than the book, because this wasn't for me. I've got The Brightest Star in the Sky by Marianne Keyes. The only reason why I picked this one up, I was walking around W.H. Smith many, many years ago, and I saw her name on it and I picked it up. I'd seen her on a few shows before and she seemed very, very funny on TV, and I thought if she's funny on TV, she might be funny in her books, and that's the only reason why I picked this up. The blurb does not, now reading it back, does not sound like anything I would remotely be interested in. It seems very slice of life, some people who share a house and their comings and goings in the house. Again, not really one that I feel particularly inclined to pick up anytime soon, and one that I've, after buying it, I kind of regretted picking it up. So I think it's just time to get rid of it, and maybe somebody else might enjoy this book. I've got The Time Traveler's Wife by Audrey Niffenegger. This has been on my shelf since I was like 16 or 17. There was a point in my life where I used to volunteer at an Oxfam shop, and they had a huge selection of books there, and they would allow me to pick up books for really, 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 really cheap. So I've got like a bunch of books that I actually own that I picked up super cheap from there at that time. But this is one that has never really intrigued me to pick up. I picked up because obviously there's loads of hype around it. I can't remember if the movie was coming out around that time. There must have been a reason I picked it up, but it sounded really cool, but I've not been very inclined to actually read it. All I know from this book is that there's a guy who's able to skip through time, and he ends up meeting his wife through or during different points in her life. So when she's really young, when she's really old, I don't really know. Sounds like he's going to be very sappy and maybe a bit sad. I'm not sure, but again, I'm not really excited to pick this one up or read it, which is why I'm letting go of it, because it's been a very long time now and I still haven't read this book. So if I've not picked up in the 10 odd years that I've owned this book, then there's really no point in still keeping it. Next up, I have The Help by Catherine Stockett. I picked this one up because there was some buzz around the movie coming up, and so I wanted to read the book first. Never really got around to it, and it's just kind of sat on my shelves ever since. I believe it follows a woman and then her two nannies. I actually don't really know too much about the plot of The Help, but I think the reason why I am unhauling this is because, to be really honest, there's been quite a lot of controversy around the book already. Viola Davis has said that it's a role that she has kind of regretted doing because of the fact that we don't really hear much of the black voices in the movie. And then also the nanny, or Catherine's nanny from her childhood, I'm not really sure where the nanny comes into her life, but she felt that the book was also based on her and so sued her as well. So it just all seems very negative, and there's a lot of negativity around the book and the author. Also, to be really, really frank, I don't really care to hear about black struggle, the black plight, or anything from somebody who hasn't experienced the black struggle. And so it's not really one, I think this is the kind of book that needs to be own voices. Like, I don't really want to hear about the struggles of being a black nanny from a white woman. Like, I'm just gonna be honest here. So I have no inclination to ever read this book, and so I don't want to own it anymore, so I'm getting rid of it. Lastly, I have Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. Jane Eyre is actually one of my favourite books. It's around a sort of gothic love story. Well, I say love story, there's a lot of nonsense that goes on in this book. It's very dark, it's very broody. I do really love this book, it's one of my favourites. But this is actually my copy that I was given in high school. I never gave it back, and it's falling apart because I've read it so many times. It's gone to countless places with me, and so at this stage I want to buy myself a really nice edition of this book. So the only reason why I'm unhauling this particular one is just because this copy is very battered and bruised. It's seen better days, but it's well loved. But I just want to get a really nice copy of this book now, so that is why I'm getting rid of this. But I still really love the book. It is problematic, it has its issues, but still, I do enjoy this book. Those are all the books that I'm getting rid of that are taking up space on my shelves. I may do another round of unhauling because there are some books that I really did love and I have reread several times, but as I've begun to read a bit more and become a little bit more of a discerning reader and someone who knows their taste a bit more, they're not books I'm sure I will enjoy rereading again. So I may unhaul them, but I'm still thinking on it. So I'll probably do a second round of books that are maybe a little bit more popular as well. We'll see. So we'll figure that out. So that is this video for today. Do let me know what you think, if there are any that I perhaps maybe should give a second chance. I will keep these on my shelves until after this video goes up, and then from there I'll get rid of them. That is it from me today. Feel free to show the like button some love, and if you would like to see more videos from me, then also subscribe, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.